This is a tale of two very, very different buildings that seem doomed to very, very similar fates. The Minchow Blacksmith Shop in Old Strathcona, and Soaring, a stunning modernist mansion in Old Riverbend. The blacksmith shop was built in 1925 by German immigrant Albert Minchow. It stands on 101st Street at 81st Avenue in what was once home to a vibrant German community. But the brick building's been empty for years, and its current owners have just applied for a demolition permit. The site is already zoned for a 12-story building, making it an anomaly in the White Avenue area. And I'm guessing the cool little smithy, which makes you feel like you've gone back in time to the Wild West, won't be standing much longer. Soaring was built in the late 1950s as the dream home for developer Sandy McTaggart and his bride Cecile. It's a stunning work of architecture, bold and playful and elegant, its glass walls offering truly remarkable river valley views. The McTaggarts gave the house and its contents to the University of Alberta in 2010. The university had been using it off and on as a conference and reception center, but says it can no longer afford the upkeep on the building, which, it says, needs at least $1.5 million in repairs. So they're taking out the plants and the art and the furniture and shuttering Soaring. There are no plans for immediate demolition, but let's be honest, the clock is ticking. These are two utterly fabulous buildings, legacies of families that built our city. Would it be more pragmatic, more utilitarian to pull them down? Absolutely. A 12-story condo tower on 101st Street might be a great way to revitalize the east end of Old Strathcona. And the university might well be far better off, selling Soaring for millions and plowing that money back into university operations. But practical, utilitarian financial decisions don't always make for beautiful, fun, memorable cities. When we can't or won't summon the will and the money to preserve our unique and memorable buildings, the buildings that give Edmonton its character and its soul, well, we all lose out.